Hello students, welcome to Rankers. Today in this session we will be discussing about 1857 revolt and some important points in 1857 revolt, and most importantly how to remember the important points of 1857 revolt. So before going to this 1857 revolt, we'll see why 1857 revolt is important in this modern Indian history. See, in the modern Indian history is divided like 1757 to 1947. But in the modern Indian history, there are two phases. One is 1757 to 1857. Second one will be 1857 to 1947. See, that means this 1857 plays a major role. That means it is dividing modern history into two equal halves, right? Now, see, what is this revolt? Why revolt has been occurred? Before going to the subject, we'll see some of the important questions. Right? The most important question in this 1857 revolt is, which of the following movements acted as the trigger of 1857 revolt, right? The options are like this. A option was failure of doctrine of labs, B option was subsidiary alliance, C option was Sepoy mutiny, and D option was killing of Mangal Pandey. So what is the question? Question is which acted as a trigger of 1857 revolt, right? To solve this question, if we see the options, all options are the reasons for 1857, but what is the question? Question is, what is the trigger? So to answer this question, what is the main thing we should know? The main thing we should know is, what do you mean by what do you mean by trigger? So what is a trigger? Trigger means the starting point of any of the big explosion. The starting point of any of big explosion will be called as a trigger. So what acted as a trigger of 1857 revolt? The thing which is acted as a trigger of 1857 revolt is, that will be called as Sepoy mutiny. That means the person called as Mangal Pandey. Mangal Pandey started the first revolt as a soldier. So that revolt will be called as Sepoy mutiny. That means Sepoy mutiny acted as trigger to the 1857 revolt. So in this question we are the other point. What is the other point? That means 1857 revolt is different from Sepoy mutiny. That means 1857 revolt started because of Sepoy mutiny, right? See, first we will see what is 1857 revolt. Before going to the 1857 revolt, why we should read about 1857 revolt and how to remember the 1857 revolt, right? So before going to the 1857 revolt, we will be seeing what is the meaning of a revolt, right? So now what is the meaning of a revolt? See, revolt is a thing which every person will be having in their life. So what is a revolt? Revolt is something, a oppression to the major thing. Like, see, every person will be having a revolt in his life. That means one or the other point of the time we revolted with our parents for any single thing. We revolted with our parents. See, daily our parents will be shouting on us, or some ex-person will be shouting on us, but we will not be responding that thing. But when we will be responding, is when our complete saturation is completed. That means when our complete patience is completed, then we will respond to the situation. That response will be very, very big outcome. That outcome will be called as a revolt. To make it more simple, we'll see the meaning of a revolt by a small example, right? See, we all know about something called as Deepavali crackers. In the Deepavali crackers, everyone knows about something called as a rocket, right? For example, please consider this as a rocket. See, I'm not a good painter, so please consider this as a rocket. So, if we consider this as a rocket, see, this rocket has a two parts. One will be a small thread which will be attached to the complete gun port inside the rocket. So what we are doing, we are igniting the rocket. When we are igniting the rocket, when we are adding some fire to this thread, this point will be called as ignition, and this thread starts burning. When this thread starts burning, the time which takes the thread to burn, that burning will be called as a burning point. See, after the complete thread has been burnt, see, directly rocket will not go into the air. What rocket will do? Starting rocket will be having a small and little explosion here. When this little explosion is there, only rocket will go to the air. If there is no little explosion, the rocket will be the same, rocket will be on the ground and rocket will not be exploding. That means, which is important for an explosion, this small bomb which we have here, that is very important for the explosion, and that explosion will be called as a trigger. So immediately after the trigger, what rocket will do? Rocket will reach the upper skies. That means, and this will be called as an explosion. See, for every rocket, how many stages we are having? We are having four stages. That means, what is the first stage? First stage is ignition, and second stage will be burning point, third stage will be trigger, and fourth stage will be explosion. If we call explosion as a revolt, so even revolt will be having four stages, right? What is the first stage? First stage is Ignition. Ignition means why people are facing a problem, right? Why people want to revert. That condition will be called as an ignition. See, after having a problem, that problem should burn to the saturation point. After problem burning to the saturation point, then the people will be waiting for trigger. See, after the trigger comes, then we'll be having a revolt, right? That trigger is at the trigger. What acted as the trigger? The trigger was acted as sepoy mutiny. So what will be the answer? Answer for the question will be sepoy mutiny. So without sepoy mutiny, there is no 1857 revolt. That means without this trigger, there is no explosion. The same way without sepoy mutiny, there is no 1857 revolt, right? But so please do understand that for anything to revolt, which is necessary, the necessary thing will be trigger. See, even though there is a ignition, even though there is a burning point, but which is necessary? The necessary thing will be trigger. Without trigger, there is no explosion, and there is no explosion and there is no revolt. Now if we are clear that for every explosion, burning point, ignition, burning point and trigger is necessary, now we will write what are the reasons for the ignition. That means why people were completely against the British, why people want to revolt, right? If we go into the story, see, our India was ruled by British from 1757 to 1757 to 1947. That means British ruled our India for nearly 200 years. In these 200 years, British, like, it is divided into two types. One will be 1757 to 1857. Second will be 1857 to 1947. Here approximately 100 years and here approximately 100 years. This rule will be called as company rule and this rule will be called as Queen's rule. That means after 1857, the company rule was completed in India and the responsibility of India was handed over to the Queen. That means 1857 brought a change of rule in India, right? That means 1857 plays a major role because people of India revolted against the company. That means people of India did not like the rule of the company. That is why they revolted on the company. When they revolted on the company, British changed it to the Queen's rule. After the Queen, this will be called as Crown's rule. Because at the time of revolt, Queen was ruling India, but after the Queen, there are kings and queens many more. That way, we will be calling it as a Crown's rule. Now, so why people revolted on the company, right? Now, why people revolted on the company? Because due to the company, people were having some problem. That problem will be calling as ignition, right? So what are the problems given by company? These problems given by company will be called as what are the reasons for the 1857 revolt. So what are the reasons for 1857 revolt? First reason will be failure of revenue policy. So what is the first reason? First reason will be the failure of revenue policies, right? What are the revenue policies? See, in India, company had three revenue policies and company was mainly focusing on money making, right? Company did not thought about the local Indian kingdom, but company mainly focused on the money making. That is why company gave three revenue policies. That will be, first one will be permanent settlement system or zamindari system. Second will be rayatwari system and third will be Mahalwari system, right? And all these three are important point for the examination. One will be the tip. All these three came parallel to the charters. What are the charters? That will be 1793, 1813, and 1833. See, there is a small tip in this modern Indian history. In modern Indian history, all numbers will be fancy numbers, right? Whatever the years you should remember, all the years will be fancy years, right? But if you see the chart tracks, how many chart tracks we are having? We are having chart tracks from 1793 to 1793, 1813, 1833, and 1853. Before chart track, we are having something called as 1773 Regulation Act. 1773 Regulation Act is the first act given to the company. But if you see here, all the years having how many years gap? They are having 20 years gap. So if you remember the rule, what is the rule? All the charters came with a gap of 20 years. Then remembering these years is very, very easy. So the most important fundamental of this history is that you should remember the years. But remembering the years will be having the trick. If you remember the trick, history will be the most important subject. And these revenue policies also came according to the It came according to the chart tracks, but all the revenue systems were failed, right? In the modern history, this revenue systems will be very important. So when the revenue systems was failure, who were completely affected? The persons who were completely affected are farmers as well as jemindars. So one section of society was affected, that is farmers, and second section will be jemindars. That means farmers and jemindars are affected by the revenue policies, and they are having some sort of problem with the British, and they want to revolt against the British. That means the reason of 1857's revolt started somewhere around 1793. That means 1857 is not at all a sudden revolt. It is a very well planned revolt by Indian people, right? Did not plan as of such, but the basic of this 1857 revolt lies somewhere around by starting of the company rule itself. The first reason for the 1857 revolt is failure of revenue policies. As these revenue policies failed, who were affected? Farmers were affected, jemindars were affected. So what is the second reason? Second reason will be called as military reason or administrative reason. What is the second reason? In the second reason, failure of administrative policies. See, what are the administrative policies? In India, for the administration of India, company gave two policies. One policy will be Subsidiary Alliance 1803 by Wellesley, and second will be Doctrine of Lapse 1853 by Lord Dalhousie, right? So one is Subsidiary Alliance, second one will be Doctrine of Lapse. What is this Subsidiary Alliance or Doctrine of Lapse? By the Subsidiary Alliance, most of the South Indian kingdoms went into the hand of company, and by the Doctrine of Lapse, the kingdoms like Satara, Jabalpur, Jhansi, Nagpur, all these areas of the Central India and the North India went into the hands of British, and these kingdoms were taken by the British forcefully. That means the kings were not willing to give this kingdom to British, but kings gave this kingdom to British by forcefully, and these systems will be called as Subsidiary Alliance by Lord Wellesley 1803 and Doctrine of Lapse by Lord Dalhousie 1853. By this, which society was affected? The society which was affected was kings was completely affected, and kings wanted to have a revolt on the British, right? But that means three important sections of the societies were affected. What are they? One is farmer, second one is jemindar, third one will be kings were also affected. Now, so what is the third reason for the 1857 revolt? The third reason for the 1857 revolt is there are some military reasons. What are the military reasons? Military reasons are Indian military was completely against the British military, because in India, British military is divided into two parts. That will be, one is Indian military, second Indian soldiers, second will be called as British soldiers. Indian soldiers were called as sepoys. Why they are called as sepoys? Because if you ever played a chess, the pawn in the chess will be called as sepoy. That means always sepoy should be standing front, and all the British soldiers are standing at the back. That means in the case of the who are standing at the front, the persons who are standing at the front is Indian soldier, that is sepoys. But that is not a problem for Indian army. But what is the problem for Indian army? The problem of Indian army is sepoys were not going above the range of Subedar. Even though they are participating in each and every war, they are not going the upper range of Subedar. But British soldiers, even though they are not participating in war, they are going beyond the point of British soldiers. That means there was some kind of official clash between Indian soldiers and British soldiers. At the same time, due to the military reforms, the culture of Indian soldiers were affected. Because Indian soldiers consist of Islam soldiers, Indian soldiers consist of Hindu soldiers, Indian soldiers consist of Sikh soldiers. Due to some military reforms, all the three classes, that is Hindus, Muslims and Sikhs, all the three classes were affected. So even military people want to have a revolt. So please remember, in the military region, we'll be not having Royal Enfield rifles, Royal Enfield rifle is the reason for Sepoy mutiny. Royal Enfield rifle is not a direct reason for 1857 revolt. Royal Enfield rifle is the direct reason for the Sepoy mutiny. So these are the military reasons. So one of the reasons we saw, one is failure of revenue policies. Second is failure of administrative policies, and third will be failure of military reforms. And fourth, there is a fourth reason. What is the fourth reason? Fourth reason is social reforms of British. What are the social reforms of British? Because the company was asked by the crown that company should not interfere into the personal things of the Indians. That personal thing means they should not interfere into religion, they should not interfere into culture, they should not interfere into tradition. But what William Bentinck did? William Bentinck intervened into our culture, and William Bentinck gave something called as abolition of sati. Abolition of sati was given by Lord William Bentinck. At the same time, we are having something called as Widow Remarriage Act. So again, Widow Remarriage Act. See, in some books, again there is a problem in history. Some books, Widow Remarriage Act is given by Lord Dalhousie. In some books, Widow Remarriage Act is given by Lord Canning. Because Widow Remarriage Act was given in 1856. So according to sources, what happened in 1856? Lord Dalhousie was transferred, and who came in the place of Lord Dalhousie? In the place of Lord Dalhousie, Lord Canning came to India. That means most of the books say Lord Dalhousie gave Widow Remarriage Act, but most of the books say, some of the books say Lord Canning gave Widow Remarriage Act. If it is the point of examination, go for Lord Dalhousie, because most of the books are believing that Lord Dalhousie gave the Widow Remarriage Act. Now, so if you see this, these are very good social reforms of British, but even though people were affected by the social reforms of British, right? No, because what is the abolition of Sati? Sati Sahagamanam. Sati Sahagamanam is the very old culture which is followed by India. We all know that what is Sati Sahagamanam? If a husband dies, wife is also forcefully cremated on the ashes of the husband. That means wife is thrown into the fire of the ashes of the husband. So this is a very old practice, and this is considered as a very bad social in India. So what William Bentinck did? William Bentinck abolished something called as sati, right? However, India is following the culture. It is good or bad, it is our culture, right? Who are the British to interfere into our culture? So most of the upper class means most of the Brahmins, Kshatriyas and Vaishyas who are following this kind of tradition are completely affected by the British. And the same thing, in India, women should not be married, right? That means if a woman marries a person and that person dies, that woman will be called as a widow. According to Indian culture, widow should never get a remarriage, right? But what these Britishers did? Britishers gave something called as even women can marry again if husband dies. The most important thing of the story is, for abolition of sati, Indian worker, and Widow Remarriage Act also Indian worker, right? On the forcing of Raja Ram Mohan Roy, William Bentinck gave something called as abolition of sati. By the work of Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar and Kandukuri Vireshlingam, the Britishers gave something called as Widow Remarriage Act. That means, even though Indians worked for the abolition of the social evils, but even still some of the upper classes were completely against the British. That means, by this, we can say that most of the sections of society were completely against the British and were completely affected by the British, right? What are societies? Farmers were affected, jemadars were affected, kings were affected, military people were affected, other sections of society were affected. Like this, everyone of the society was affected. Now, India is having something called as, if you take the same example of the rocket, India is having something called as ignition, and India also completed something called as burning point. Now what we are waiting for? We are waiting for the trigger. Again remember, without trigger rocket is a zero, right? Without trigger revolt will be zero. So now we are waiting for a trigger. The trigger came in the form of 1857 Royal Enfield Rifles. So that trigger came in the form of 1857 Royal Enfield Rifles. What is this Royal Enfield? Today we have a very big two-wheelers automobile company called as Royal Enfield, which will be supplying the two-wheelers automobiles called as Bullet, Classic, everything, right? The same Royal Enfield company was originally, it is an ammunition supply company, right? But if you see the bikes called as Bullet, the Royal Enfield bike, you will see the symbol of the Royal Enfield. The symbol of the Royal Enfield will be having something called as canon. What is a canon? Canon, what is a canon? Canon in the local language will be called as Firangi, right? Firangi means it is a very big type of a gun. So actually Royal Enfield was supplying something called as ammunition. The same Royal Enfield company gave a gun called as Royal Enfield Rifle. When they gave a gun called as Royal Enfield Rifle and they introduced the gun into something called as Indian Sepoys. That means all the Indian Sepoys should be using something called as Royal Enfield Rifle. They should be using Royal Enfield Rifle. Actually, the Royal Enfield Rifle is a new technologized gun in the time of 1857. So all Indian Sepoys should be using the Royal Enfield Rifle. But this Royal Enfield Rifle will be having a cartridge. In the cartridge will be having the bullets. So it is the rule of this Royal Enfield Rifle. Before uploading the cartridge should be bitten, because cartridge will be like this and cartridge will be having a pin, right? This pin should be taken by the mouth, because in one hand you will be carrying the gun, in the other hand you will be having the cartridge. See, you cannot open the pin of the cartridge with your hand. So what you should do, you should open the pin with your mouth. So for the pin, what these people use something called as a grease over here, right? As this pin should come, they use something called as grease. And there was a rumor. What is the rumor? The grease by which pin was joined, the grease was having something called as pig fat and cow fat. When this Royal Enfield, there is a rumor that it was having pig fat and cow fat. See, Indian Sepoys consists of Hindus, Muslims and Sikhs. For Hindus, cow is considered as a very sacred animal. So they denied to use Royal Enfield rifle. And for Muslims, pig is considered as a banished animal, abandoned animal, right? Muslims doesn't even like to see the pig, because pig is considered as an abandoned animal in this Quran. So for Muslims, cow is a very, very sacred animal. For Muslims, pig is a very abandoned animal, right? That means even Hindus rejected to use this Royal Enfield rifle, and Muslims rejected to use the Royal Enfield rifles. But however, British military forced Indian soldiers to use the Royal Enfield rifle. So aggravated Indian soldiers on 29th March, in 34th Native Regiment of Barakpur. Barakpur is in Bengal. Barakpur, we have a person called as Mangal Pandey, right? Mangal Pandey, who was vexed by the actions of East India Company. Mangal Pandey revolted against the British by shooting his higher official, right? He shot his higher official and started something called as Sepoy Meeting, right? When Mangal Pandey shot his higher official, all the other regiments also started shooting their higher officials and forming into a revoltist. And this revoltist turned into a very big revolt on something called as May 10th. 1857 revolt. That means on 29th March we have something called as first Sepoy mutiny. Later, up to from 29th March to 10th May, there are many Sepoy mutinies. On 10th May, we are having a Sepoy mutiny in the Gwalior. That means all the Sepoys revolted against the British, and Sepoy mutiny acted as a trigger. Without Sepoy mutiny, there was no 1857 revolt. So which acted as a trigger? The trigger was Sepoy mutiny. That means, if you remember the concept, right? See, let me give an advice on the history. See, history is nothing but our life. History is nothing but our life. What actually happened in our life is present in the history. Now, if we take it as a simple sense, in the life, everyone had a revolt. That means, you shouted at your mother, I shouted at my mother. But will die shout at our mother? No, when will be shouting at our mother? When we are completely vexed by the actions of our parents, when our complete saturation has been completed, then we will be revolting on our parents, or we will be revolting on our friends or girlfriends, etc. That means, when we will be having a revolt? When we are completely vexed. And India was also having a revolt. When India had a revolt? When India was completely vexed. So, if you make the subject simple, if you link the subject to your life and take the subject with an example, then the subject will be very, very easy.
Thanks for watching Rankers Hub. For more such videos, please do subscribe to our channel, do like our videos and share all our videos. Thank you so much.